Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching for today. Generic system images, that is GSR, are providing unlimited possibilities including exploring different operating systems on any device. From last few months, I reviewed almost all stable Android system custom GSR ROM which will boot and work on any Android device. You will find its playlist in video description. But if you move forward and try some vendor-specific ported ROM by Mystic GSR World, you can literally boot any operating system like HyperOS, oneui, OxygenOS, miui, realme UI on any device. Who tried such vendor-specific HyperOS 2.0.2 port from Xiaomi's 15 Ultra device? And it is booted and working very well on my OnePlus 9RT. Today in this video, we are going to review this build, which have amazing features resembles with OxygenOS 15. At the end, we reviewed some bugs and given some important points how to boot such build on any treble supported devices. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. I booted this vendor-specific ROM ported by Mystic Developers team on my OnePlus 9RT. Vendor-specific ported GSR ROM will not boot on all devices like custom GSR ROM. It needs some specific requirements that I discussed at the end of this video. If you check about device section of this ROM, this is Xiaomi's HyperOS 2.0.2. As I booted this build through DS loader, it's showing 10 GB of allocated storage for this ROM. This is Xiaomi's HyperOS 2.0.2 Android 15 build. It has security patches of May 2025. The last ported build we reviewed was on December security patches. Except that other things will remain same like stock primary ROM of your device. I tested some important things which needs for daily use of such ROMs and all of them are working properly like Wi-Fi, hotspot, NFC, GPS, Bluetooth with HD audio codecs, 4G LTE calling with dual SIM is working, but there is a small trick to force enable 4G LTE network that I shown in the bug section of this video. All sensors are working. I tested them using device info and sensor application and there are no issues I found. I have given the link of both sub application in video description. You can test them for your device also. Let's check out some amazing features of HyperOS which resembles with OxygenOS 15. First one is HyperOS wallpapers. HyperOS offers some unique live wallpapers in wallpaper setting, but special one is super wallpapers. These are the wallpapers which have different animations when you turn screen on and off on the lock screen. For wallpapers of planners, who gets even additional landing points which will be displayed after unlocking of your device. These wallpapers look stunning while turning screen on and off along with unlocking of your device. This feature is not available in OxygenOS 15. Next is depth wallpaper. While applying wallpapers with bigger subject, you get depth wallpaper toggle. If you enable this toggle, the subjects of wallpaper like this flower of this wallpaper will be displayed over lock screen clock or any text which gives stunning look to lock screen. Except this, we get lots of customizations for wallpaper, like we can add wallpaper blur effect, lens effect and glass effect. For glass effect, we can use matte finish effect also. These types of wallpaper customizations are also available in OxygenOS 15, but HyperOS offers something different called as dynamic wallpaper. These are live wallpapers which shows the animation effect on lock screen and even after unlocking your device. You can check here some of dynamic wallpapers which give stunning look on lock screen and on home screen. For some customizable wallpapers, you can change total and background text colors. After customizations of these wallpapers, they look great along with this lock screen text. Next is new HyperOS stunning and smooth transition animations in overall system. We also get OxygenOS 15 like user interface for QoS panel. Split mode is available so we can access notification panel by dragging from left side and QoS panel from right top side of your display. Like OxygenOS 15, OK, smooth multi-window multitasking. Just drag currently running application to top left or right side. It snaps that application in multi-window screen. You can maximize or minimize this app multi-window to any size. By using swipe up gesture from bottom bar, you can close this application window easily. When you get any heads up notification, you can open that application in multi-window by dragging it to center of the screen. You can snap multi-window screen of application to edges of the screen and can open them anytime we want. We can use main background application and multi-window application both at the same time. This is called as multi-screen control, which was currently introduced by OnePlus in OxygenOS 15 V840 update. We can open two different application windows at the same time using side toolbox feature of HyperOS. Side toolbox offers same features like OxygenOS smart sidebar, but this toolbox gives some extra features like game shortcuts, video toolbox for videos and call toolbox for caller screen. When you are in any call and then access side toolbox, you get call toolbox feature, which gives call conversation in a text format, similar like voice notes feature of OxygenOS 15. By default, it will give Chinese language, but you can switch to English also. This is a feature of HyperOS, which interprets the ongoing calls in a notes format and save it in Mi Notes application. This is similar like AI voice notes feature of OxygenOS 15. Even call recording is working in this dialer. Once you stop the call, you get its AI notes and call recording in call summary of that number. As I don't have Mi Notes application installed, it didn't showing call notes, but call recording is working. Next is video toolbox. When you play video in any application and then open side toolbox, you get this feature. It has option to take screenshot of videos or to record that video. Even you get inbuilt cast option to cast video content immediately on your Android TV. One of the special feature I like most is turn screen off while videos are playing. This turns off the screen but audio still works in a background.
It's new officially supported JSA build for all treble supporting dynamic system devices. Maintainer of this build is closed off. Security patches of this build is updated July 2025.
So you don't need YouTube Premium subscription for this feature, which is exclusive for premium members only. This works for all video applications. Next, if you play games, you get game toolbox similar like OxygenOS 15 Game Space. It offers several options to change performance mode. It helps to take screenshot or to record video gameplays and many more. So these are all some main features of HyperOS 2.0. If you ask about the performance, it's top-notch. It's running like Ferrari on the road. Everything is buttery smooth, apps opening, closing, switching between applications, scrolling, system transition animations. Even new user interface of HyperOS gives next level of look and performance to your old device. But there are some bugs and some can be solvable. Let's check out them. Some applications still runs with the Chinese language like Xiaomi app, marketplace, etc. Even while using ROM, some system pop-ups may remain in a Chinese language. Xiaomi assistant will also work in Chinese language only. After first boot, everything will be in the Chinese language. To solve this, go to the setting, then select second last option from bottom, then select second option from the top. Next, select first option, then choose English language. This will turn your system language into the English. After flashing ROM, keyboard may have Chinese language and weird layout. To solve this, tap on this option, then select this option. It will turn into the English keyboard. Later, once you enable the Google Play Store, you can install and use any keyboard applications like SwiftKey. To enable Google Play Store, open Xiaomi's Market application, then search for Play Store, update application and open it. Now set up Google account. Now you can able to use Google Play Store and Google applications without any issues. Punch hole camera cutout is perfect, but clock icon in the status bar will misalign with cutout. We cannot able to solve this issue even after using display cutout option available in the developer setting. After first boot, 4G network will not work, but to solve this, go to dialer, there type hash star 4636 hash star. New network interface will open, there select only LTE mode. Now we can able to use 4G network and LTE calling. Next one is a major issue, you cannot able to log in into the Xiaomi's account in this ROM. It stuck on checking password. Because of this issue, we can't able to use HyperOS AI features. Fingerprint and face unlock are not working in this build. So you have to rely on the password or pattern lock for now. Overall, this build is pretty useful and can be used as alternative of OxygenOS 15. Some old devices can also try this if they are eager to test HyperOS or OxygenOS 15 features. But booting up such ported ROM is not easy task. These ROMs only boots on the kernel version 5+. Kernel must be permissive and your Android verified boot must be disabled. Please check tutorial link given in the description for this process. Even after following these things, I can't guarantee it will boot for all devices, so you have to try it yourself. This is all about for today guys, hope you liked our work, then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming adventurous content. Thanks for watching, see you next time, take care, bye bye.